In this lesson, I'm going to give you a quick overview on the core functionality of Google Tag Manager, why it's such an awesome tool for your tracking needs, and how you can use it to level up your digital marketing efforts. All and more coming up, so let's dive in. Hi there, and welcome to another video of MeasureSchool.com, where we teach you the data-driven way of digital marketing. In this first lesson of our Google Tag Manager for Beginners series, I'm going to show you the core functionality of Google Tag Manager and why it's such an awesome tool. Now, before we get started, if you want to check your knowledge after this video, head over to MeasureSchool.com/lesson1, where we have a little bit of a quiz prepared for you that you can go through and test your knowledge and see if you have understood everything. But we still have lots to cover, so let's dive in. So let's start out with the problem here. If you have a website just like this online shop and you want to add tracking or marketing functionality to the website, you will often be asked by outside third-party tools to install a JavaScript tracking code. So for example, here for Google Analytics, they ask you to install a JavaScript tracking code onto your website. The same is the case for AdWords if you want to take advantage of the remarketing feature. And for example, also this is the case for the Facebook pixel. And really, it's always the same. They ask you to place one JavaScript onto the HTML code of your page, mostly in the head of the HTML code. But especially if you have a bigger site, you might need to consult your developer to build that in for you so you can use the marketing or tracking functionality of these third-party vendors. The problem is you actually need to place it inside of the HTML itself, so you need to have access to your website. For example, in this case, if I click on this website with the right click, I can go into View Page Source and we can scroll down here. We can see which tracking codes are installed. So in our case here, we have the Facebook pixel code. We have also Google Analytics. And down here we have the Google remarketing code. And this is also confirmed by our tools here that we have installed. The tag is system by Google. We can see Google Analytics is installed and remarketing, and also our Facebook pixel. This is fine so far, but you need to have access to actually deploy these codes. So let's see how Google Tag Manager handles this. We go over to our demo shop here, which is another site where I have Google Tag Manager installed. And we can see in the plugins that we have installed here, the Google Tag Assistant, that we have the same tags installed, Google Analytics, Google Remarketing, and additionally Google Tag Manager, plus the Facebook pixel. Now the difference is when we look into the page source, we can't find really our codes except of the Google Tag Manager code. And this is really what Google Tag Manager does. It helps you to deploy other tracking codes through one central JavaScript code that you need to install on your page. And through this script, we'll be able to deploy our marketing tags with ease. Once you have this Google Tag Manager code installed on all your pages, you'll be able to manage your tracking and marketing scripts, also referred as marketing tags, in a central management console. And it looks a little bit like this. So here we are in our Google Tag Manager account. And from here, we can manage all our marketing tags. So if you click over to tags, we can actually see which tags are currently deployed on our website. To make this a little bit more visual, Google Tag Manager has a great feature called the Preview and Debug console, which you can activate under this Publish button and here under Preview. This will put your browser into a special state, which will allow you to test and debug your implementation. So if you go back to your website where you have Google Tag Manager installed, you can reload this website. And you see that there's a little console that pops up at the bottom. And this really is only happening for you and not for other users that visit your website at this time, because you have Google Tag Manager open on the other tab here. And what this console allows us to do is see much more information about what tags have been deployed on your website. So if you go to over to another site here, you can again see which tags are fired. They are always the same because we configured them to fire on any side of our website. But Google Tag Manager is actually really good in handling exceptions. So if you only want to fire a tag on a certain page, you can configure that within the management console. Now, as the name implies, Google Tag Manager is really good at managing tags. So you have an overview in this tool where you can see and configure new and existing tags. So for example, here with our Google Analytics tag, we can click into it and see all the configurations, especially if we have done any kind of special configurations to them. And so we can keep a record of the tag and the configurations that are currently deployed. This is much more readable than installing this JavaScript and looking up in the source code which configurations have been deployed. As you can see, it gives us a great overview on which tag has been deployed with which configurations, and also what rule or trigger is attached to deploy this marketing tag. In our case, we have a all pages trigger deployed, and triggers are really just rules to determine when a tag should be deployed on the user's browser. The good thing, triggers can be reused. So for example, this all pages trigger has been attached to multiple of our tags. Now let's go into a little bit of an example here to show you the power of a tag deployment, because Google Tag Manager makes it really easy to deploy a tag, and it actually takes you through the steps. So for example, we can give our tag a name. We can choose the product. We can choose the tag type here. Enter our tracking ID. Choose the configurations. Don't worry if you don't understand what I'm doing right now. This is something we are gonna explore in later lessons in more detail. And in the last step, we can attach a trigger. Now, as the name implies of my tag, I don't want to fire this on all the pages. I want to actually fire a Google Analytics event upon a add to cart click. And here's another power of Google Tag Manager. It doesn't restrict you in just deploying a tag based on the page that the user is on right now, but you can actually build custom triggers that allow you to deploy a tag based on an interaction. So let's do this here. We can create this trigger and attach it to our tag. Create this tag. And we have a new tag in our queue here. What we can do right now is test this tag before we actually deploy it to all our users, so you can make sure that it works correctly. All we need to do is go into the preview and debug mode. And now we can go back to our page, reload our page. In our case, we want to test a add to cart click, so we need to go to a product page. And I click on this add to cart button. It opens up a new tab, and we can see that our Google Analytics event has fired when we clicked the add to cart button. So now the information should have been sent over to Google Analytics. We can also look into our tool here and see that we have an event call that happened with our filled out information here. That would also be possible to see in our real-time reporting under events. We see that a event just happened. So this is a really easy way to deploy a tag and configure it and test it out. But we have actually not yet deployed this tag to all our users. This is only functioning on our browser, which is very handy if we have more complicated tag deployments and need to test our implementation before we go into production with it or live onto the website. So the last step is actually publishing this as a version to all our users. How do we do this? By simply pressing this publish button here. Once we have tested everything and published this now. So now it will be available to track the interactions of all our users. And Google Tag Manager does it this way because there's actually a built-in version control into the system as well. So up here under the version menu, you'll be able to see which versions have been published in your account, and you'll be able to reverse or go back to an older version if something broke in your last deployment. So there you have it, a quick overview on Google Tag Manager. Now, did you understand everything? Well, test your knowledge by heading over to measureschool.com/lesson1, where we have a quiz prepared for you that you can go through and see if you understood everything that we taught in this video. And afterwards, we'll send you some more resources to deepen your knowledge. Now, if you enjoyed this lesson, then join me at the lesson number 2, where we are going to discover on how to install Google Tag Manager correctly on your website. My name is Julian. Till next time.